Sultan Hotel. Another one over there. Yes. What's the name? Crescent or something?
Skyness.
Skyness.
Yes. That one.
That one is Skyness. Another hotel, Skyness Hotel in Britannia. We have a stadium actually. And actually, Dura Stadium is also owned by the owner of the Italian Nature Conservancy. The owner is called Ndura. So we have a stadium here by him, it's called Ndura Stadium. Italian Nature Conservancy. A long time ago we used to say Ndura Park. Ndura Park. What's the name of this place?
This place is called Namawanga.
Oh, Namawanga?
Yes, Namawanga.
Where does Bobby start from? It's also part of the
Kibombe.
This Namawanga and also part of Kibombe. KITALE, where do you prefer to ask?
Nairobi is so good, but KITALE actually is now it's so good. But hapo nyuma ilikuwa mbaya, iko.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, you prefer going back to Nairobi soon?
For searching for job.
For?
For job.
For job.
Yeah.
Okay. And in this your motorbike.
And this.
So if this is yours, then it's all good because the one you get is fully yours.
Yes, yes.
If you are for somebody else, then it will be very taxing.
Yeah.
And how is business so far?
My business is I'm renting motorbike, but I have some MPESA at my home.
You have?
I have my MPESA.
MPESA?
Yeah, my own MPESA.
Oh, your own MPESA?
Yeah.
So you do this and also do a best day. That's awesome. You know how to answer. down somewhere there. Conservancy. I need to take a photo here. Can you take me a photo?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll appreciate it. Use my phone. I want to take a thumbnail for this video here. Here we go. Also take this way.
Okay, the selfie.
And take this way so that the whole of KITALE Nature Conservancy, the wildings are shown. So maybe I should stand here. Okay. All right. So can I send you using MPESA?
It's okay.
Okay. MPESA number. Zero seven twenty seven twenty seven twenty seven twenty seven sixty five eleven. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Chaleta jina gani?
Emily.
Yeah, Emily.
Yes.
You see Brian. Brian, yeah.
Brian.
Yeah. Yeah. I appreciate so much. Nice meeting you.
Okay.
What's your name once again?
My name is Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Nickname called Nyashinsky.
Nyashinsky?
Yes.
Oh, you are a fan of Nyashinsky?
Yes.
My name is Brian Anoto. And my YouTube channel is called Anoto in China.
Okay.
Anoto in China.
I will follow you.
Okay, Anoto in China.
Yes.
Oh, thank you so much.
Okay.
Okay, let me just walk because I want to walk for the best part of the day.
Okay.
Yeah.
We shall meet.
Yeah, this number, can I call you some other time?
Yes, you can call me.
I want to do a tour of KITALE.
Oh, you can call me back then I will come to pick you.
So you will tour me around KITALE?
Yes.
Okay, I will call you Emily. This
Emily,
number.
Emily.
Okay, when I call it, it's your name?
Yes.
My name is
Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
I have another number,
okay.
01, like that.
Okay.
But this I'm using for MPESA.
Okay, so tomorrow you take me a tour around town.
Yes.
So you tell me how much it will be tonight.
Yes.
And then I wake up in the morning, I'll call you, we do a tour. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, all right.
That is Nyashinsky. Oh, amazing guy. And here we are at KITALE Nature Conservancy. You can see this building once caught fire. This one, when we were in high school, this part caught fire. And now they are rehabilitating it one more time. Let me show you from this place. This place caught fire and it's being rehabilitated. Yeah, you can see the wall. And we have some amazing decorations. This should be an antelope or maybe a waterbuck or something. I'm not so sure about it. I don't know. I'm having some hard moment here, but it's okay. So here we are. See this police? He's welcoming you to the Conservancy. And this is creative art foot nuts. You can see what's happening here. Right, so let me take you through KITALE Nature Conservancy. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Fine.
What's the entry fee nowadays?
150.
150?
Mm.
And long time ago?
150.
150? Mm. Okay, can I pay using MPESA?
Mm.
All right.
Or even cash?
I prefer M-Pesa.
Okay.
Yeah. My friend is calling me. Let me call you. Let me call you in a few. Okay. So, pay bill or buy goods? Buy goods. Click on M-Pesa. Buy goods. What's the till number?
122 144 744 744.
Store number? Oh, 150. Italian Nature Conservancy. Oh, Brian. Yeah, we see Brian. Who amongst you is well knowledgeable about this place?
Each one of us.
Who can go with me and show me places? And maybe it will be more of a conversation of what's happening, of the things we see.
Mm.
Yeah.
Who will you choose between the two?
They will choose. I don't like choosing. So you select one of yourself and then we go. Oh, okay, it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. I hope you are not camera shy.
Is this my camera?
Yeah, I'm doing a vlog about this place, so it will add more value if you have a conversation. But it's just normal conversation. Do you normally do tour guide here, right?
Mm.
Yeah, it's just the same. I assume. Okay, okay. It's okay. All right. Oh, I know that. No, you don't need to tell me. Yeah. Right. So, what's your name?
Sharon.
Sharon. Yeah. Nice to meet you, Sharon. My name is Brian. Or the name I prefer most is my African name.
Okay.
Brian Anoto. So, the name of my YouTube channel is Anoto in China.
Wow.
Yeah, Anoto in China. Nice to meet you. You can introduce yourself officially here.
Oh, I'm Sharon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, from Kenya.
From Kenya.
Yeah.
Awesome. Which part of Kenya?
Vihiga.
Vihiga.
Yeah.
Awesome. And where are we right now?
KITALE Nature Conservancy.
KITALE Nature Conservancy.
Yeah.
And you are going to take us. We are so many people here. Maybe you might seem just me and you, but we are so many people here. Let's tour, and we are glad that you are hosting us today.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. How many minutes or how many hours does it take going around?
Like 40 minutes.
Oh, 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Then that one you can do. Is there a formula we start from somewhere or?
You can start from here, but it's botanical garden.
Botanical garden?
Yeah.
Or this botanical garden.
Yeah.
Maybe we can do a bit of it. Just like 3 minutes and then we proceed.
Yeah, in this botanical garden,
mm-hmm.
we have different 800 indigenous species of trees,
mm-hmm.
and they are named according to their genus and species name.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the double naming system of organism.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they are arranged according to their families, but different species.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they are planted in that order.
Yeah.
Of the families, and then
and species.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe we can go in and we see what's happening. This is the botanical garden. So you are saying we also have
medicinal trees, mm-hmm. others love trees, mm-hmm. like, yeah.
Love trees?
Yeah. We have so many trees.
What are they?
We also have biblical trees.
Biblical?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know.
The trees that were named in the Bible.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. Like which one?
Juniperus prosperus. Mm-hmm. The cedar, mm-hmm. yenye ilitumika kunda Arki ya Noah.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah.
So cedar, which was used to make the Noah's Ark.
Uh-huh. Then we have the Phoenix reclinata, mm-hmm. yenye ilitumika during entry into Jerusalem.
Entry into Jerusalem. Yeah. The one that...
The Makindu.
The Makindu, yeah, yeah. The one that Jesus used. Yeah. That was laid on the road when Jesus was triumphing into Jerusalem.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Then... We have Sisyphus Mokranta, mm-hmm. the one that turned 360 degrees, mm-hmm. then it was used on Jesus' head.
What's the name of that?
Sisyphus Mokranta.
Sisyphus Mokranta.
Yeah.
It sounds romantic. Sisyphus Mokranta.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. What's that Sisyphus Mokranta?
It's there down.
Can we access it?
Yeah.
Okay. We just see a few and then we leave this place. Normally, like most of my life, okay, this year I've spent my time in China, and in their botanical garden, you see how they are naming this. So then they have attached a scan, a QR code to every tree with a brief information. So for example, such a tree like this one is called Senna. Spectabilis. So somewhere here they have put a tag, you scan with your phone and it will give you all the details about that tree. Mm. But in Kenya I've not seen that anywhere.
Yeah,
but in Kunming Institute of Botany, Botanical Garden, yeah. in Kunming City, Yunnan Province, they have documented their trees very, very nice. I've shown that in other episodes.
Yeah. Yeah.
But at least maybe that technology will come to this place.
Yeah, and then this one is aloe champeriana.
Aloe?
Champeriana.
Champeriana.
Yeah, that was mixed with that olive oil that was used to paka mwili wa Yesu.
Oh, aloe vera was also used by Jesus?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
This is ficus bubu, the love tree.
This one?
Yeah.
Ficus?
Bubu.
Bubu?
Yeah.
Why is this called bubu?
I don't know, but...
Oh, the love tree?
Yeah, it's the love tree.
Why do you call it love tree? You can see so many people...
Yeah, it's believed that when you write your name there,
oh.
and for your partner, you'll not go apart.
If I write my name here and my partner, yeah. don't go apart.
Yeah, you'll just be together forever.
For real? That's why we have so many names.
Yeah.
Let's see, like, Derek... This one seems to be written so many years ago. And Kennedy...
We have Abiud.
Abiud, where are the ladies? Like here, Doreen and Carlos.
Yeah.
Which other ones? I need to see one more lady. One more lady. Enoch and somebody. Lady, I don't know what's this. Okay, let's, one more, don't worry. Like Cha and Brian. Ah, Brian, we are represented. Maybe this is Cha something. Charlie or Shirley and Brian. So it's believed that when you write your name here with your loved ones, you won't separate.
Yeah, you won't separate. You just be together.
For real?
Yeah, it's believed like that.
Ficus.
Bubu.
Ficus Bubu.
Yeah.
Ficus Bubu. The love tree, if you write your name there, you won't be separated with your loved one. Awesome, I didn't know that. You know, if I was walking alone now with such an information, I would not know it. So we're looking for the tree they tied around Jesus. This one?
Yeah.
Sisyphus Micromta. This is the tree.
Yeah.
And actually, let me show you. It's somewhat this way, but this one, as it's shaded because of the rain.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it should have the thorns.
But it has little thorns.
Oh, little thorns.
Yeah.
This one. So this one was the one that was used to tie Jesus around. This is the first Mkronta. Awesome. I didn't know about that, and I didn't know about this ficus tree.
Ficus bubu.
Ficus bubu. But why is it called bubu? Bubu is somebody who does not talk. Bubu. But love doesn't tell the tale.
Yeah.
Is your name written there?
Yeah, my name is there.
Oh, so, okay, there's also a name here. People love to write on the aloe vera.
Yes.
So, when did you write your name?
September.
You wrote it, you and somebody?
Yeah.
Okay, who's the name? Or do you want to keep it a secret?
Yeah, that's my secret.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. And also,
even this one, you see here, a love tree again.
Oh, this one is also a love tree.
Yeah.
What's the name of this?
This is called, I don't know it's in botanical name.
You know it in which name?
The other name.
There's a name. This tree, it's called something. And we read about it in
Cactus.
Should it be Cactus Toningi? I think so.
Yeah.
Cactus Toningi. Yeah. So it's also the love tree, right?
Yeah.
So why should it be a love tree, this one? Because of the shape of the heart?
Yeah. It has this heart shape, love shape.
Okay. And people also write on this.
Yeah.
Let me see a good name, like Justin Avon, I don't know. Let me look for one name that is Zini, like white. The names are not really, maybe this Ruth Sivioi and June Sivioi. Maybe this are family members, but it's been written all over the Cactus Toningi. Also, this is a cactus?
No, this is Cafe Ugandensis.
Cafe Ugandensis?
Yeah.
Oh. I used to call this a cactus. Yeah. Awesome. That's a nice piece of information. And also, you are aware, you know the medicinal ones and the diseases they treat?
Yeah, but they are there. We have Technolia nobilis, we have Alungana madagascarensis, but Alungana madagascarensis, then we have Wabugia, Ugandensis.
Like the ones you are mentioning, which disease do they treat?
Like Wabugia, you teeth.
Okay. Or you brush with it?
Yeah.
Oh, and it cures maybe the bleeding gums.
Yeah, and then Teclea nobilis is about infertility.
Okay.
This one here, Gardenia tanifolia, this is believed by West Pokot people that when you plant it in the entrance of the homestead, it protects the homestead.
This tree right here?
Yeah.
What's the name again?
Gardenia tanifolia.
Gardenia califolia.
Tanifolia.
Gardenia tanifolia. Yeah. Believed that by the Pokot, West Pokot is a tribe in Kenya.
Yeah.
That when you plant it on the entrance like here,
it protects the homestead.
Oh.
Yeah. That's what? Even as you have just planted.
Oh, on the entrance
of the homestead.
What? I didn't know about that. What is that one tree that's very unique around here that you might not have mentioned?
Like that one, Vanguera apiculata.
This one?
This is used by the Italian genes.
Vanguera apiculata.
Yeah.
This one.
When they want to cook their ugali, they usually start with it first,
out,
and then it becomes thick, and then they start cooking their ugali.
Like the wood of this tree, or?
No. You see this tree, it usually be like this.
Yeah.
This, this way. Then they do like this.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Like that.
And then it makes the ugali thick.
Yeah, then they start cooking now.
Oh, okay, okay.
Then we have Mondia White, the Mkombero.
Where is Mkombero, by the way?
It's there.
Mkombero is actually like the natural Viagra here in Kenya. I've never seen it plant, but it looks like this.
It's there.
Okay. The natural Viagra by Mother Nature. Let's see if it is standing out or if it is a fallen tree. Mukombero. Yeah. The one on the farthest?
Yeah.
The natural Viagra. This one?
Yeah.
This one?
This one. Yeah, that tree. It's called Mundi.
This one?
Yeah.
So where is the part that people normally eat?
See, they usually say that they eat the roots.
Oh, the roots.
Yeah.
It's called Mondia.
Whittle.
Whittle. Mondia whittle. So this one, when you eat the root, you become very active.
Yeah, it stimulates the blood.
And is it proven scientifically?
Yeah, it's true.
Oh. Mm. How do you know? Mondia whitening. Whittle. Yeah. The natural Viagra. Nature's a very unique way of providing for those who need to be provided. Awesome. And this is the Kitale Nature Conservancy Botanical Garden. Yeah. You guys go watch the botanical garden in Kunming, China, in my previous episodes and compare it with this one and tell me what you think. Right, we proceed.
Then here is all about evolution according to Charles Darwin.
Okay, okay.
How man evolved.
So this
the
is
the first stage.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So this was the first man.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I'm not so familiar with history. Mm-hmm. I'm a geography person.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is all about evolution.
So we started here, yeah, and then went to Theropithecus Africanus.
Yeah.
And then I'm looking for Homo sapiens, but Homo sapiens should be somewhere there.
Then Kenyapithecus.
Why Kenyapithecus?
See, he was the third stage.
Okay. So this one was found in Kenya.
Yeah.
Kenyapithecus. Because yeah, they say Kenya remains is the origin of the motherland.
Yeah, his remains were found in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Kenyapithecus. And
Australopithecus.
This one was Australia. Australopithecus was found in Australia, right? And then also that, and Homo habilis, the famous Homo habilis, and also this Homo habilis
robustus,
and Homo erectus, also very very common name in history, and finally the upright man.
Yeah, yeah. Homo sapien.
Homo sapien. Homo sapien. This one. So, for those who are lovers of history, the history of humanity has been documented here very well. Now this is the complete Homo sapien.
Homo sapien sapien.
What? Why? Is he a politician? Because he has the big stomach. The Homo sapien. Looks like a busy guy, has a phone, goggles, a red suit, black trouser, and this weird weird shoe, Homo sapien. So for those who are interested about the history of mankind, there you go. And it is believed that Kenya is the home of humanity.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we've seen Kenyapithecus. Maybe the Turkana boy. This and what do you say? Some remains of a boy that they say that's the ancient man. No, very, very ancient Turkana boy in
it's
Turkana.
In Kenya.
Yeah, so they say it's supposed the theory that the first man lived in Kenya.
In Kenya.
So whenever you come to Kenya, you are home.
Yeah.
This is home. Awesome. Well documented. Then we're going to the land of paradise. You can see what's happening here. What? You guys are very serious about these things. So what's happening here?
This area now is biblically called mountain, where many occasions in the Bible were occurring. Like here,
It's the story about Noah and the ark.
Okay.
Yeah.
Noah and the ark. So Noah is that person?
Yeah, Noah is there offering sacrifice to God for protecting him. He was not carried by floods.
Let me show them Noah. I tell you.
It looks real. Noah offering the sacrifice. And that's the ark.
Oh my. So what else is also happening here? The story of Jesus, how he was crucified.
Yeah, mm-hmm. When Jesus was crucified on the cross, mm-hmm. then immediately when he said it is finished, mm-hmm. the veil in the temple splitted into two.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have also shown that veil.
Yeah, there's a veil there in the temple which splitted into two.
This one?
Yeah.
And who is this?
Aaron.
Aaron. Yeah. Was Aaron in the temple then?
Yeah.
When the temple, when the Shia was split into two?
Yeah, he was in the temple.
Temple with a split of way. And it should be Jesus.
And the snake, the pig.
These are the unclean animals.
Okay. Yeah. I feel like we're missing something. Okay. So people should not eat these animals.
Yeah. The snake.
Snake. Pig.
Donkey. Raven. All these animals.
Oh man. Which animal have you ever eaten in this?
Pig.
Pig.
Yeah.
Do you think pig is something? Okay. Basically, it's normally very dirty, but if you slaughter it and prepare it well, it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. In China, I ate the donkey. So sweet.
Donkey.
Yeah, donkey. It's very, very sweet. This one. Let me show them how they have animated it. This one.
The donkey, the snake, the pig, and vultures, and what have you.
Yeah, it's so sweet, actually. Donkey meat's very, very sweet. You should have a taste. I'm looking for a place where they sell donkey meat here.
In Kenya, we don't sell donkey meat.
But we have a slaughterhouse in Naivasha. Maybe they import outside. I don't know, export, maybe. I don't know. Have we missed anything on the other end? It was just the story about the ark.
It was just the story about the ark.
Okay, okay.
No,
and the rainbow.
Yeah.
LGBTQ. Okay, okay. Where do we start from?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is called the Garden of Gethsemane, where
garden.
Jesus mm-hmm. went with his three disciples, John, Peter, and James, to pray.
Mm-hmm.
And while Jesus was praying, the three disciples fell asleep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Here is Jesus praying.
Okay. This is Jesus.
Yeah.
Hey, Jesus. Let me touch Jesus. Oh, man. Awesome. And,
then here is Jesus entering Jerusalem.
Jesus entering.
Using a small colt.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And when he was entering, the women at the entrance started singing, Hosanna, Hosanna, here comes the Messiah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Then they started splitting that when it's the clenata
mm-hmm.
and the road so that Jesus can pass through.
Yeah, that name, you're saying it very fast. It looks like a tongue twister. So say it slowly.
Oh, it's called Phoenix.
Phoenix.
Reclinata.
Reclinata.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or basically the
Makindu.
Makindu.
Yeah.
Yeah. Makindu is also that one.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll show them. So this is also Jesus. I'm with Jesus here.
Then yeah, Jesus carrying his cross,
uh-huh.
ready to be crucified.
Okay.
And while he was carrying his cross, uh-huh. there was a soldier here who was whipping Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Then Jesus fell down because the cross had become heavy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So this Jesus falling down because of this guy, very bad guy,
yeah.
whipping him. Okay. Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. Mambo, umeleta familia?
Eh, hey, mwakuja waijue kidogo.
Okay, me I'm being familiar.
Yeah, ni poa.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Hey, yes.
Yeah, we just document the place so that it will be memorable.
Yeah.
At least it's good when you bring the young ones to learn about this place and the biblical stories.
Yeah. That's very nice. I am happy that I need my children to know.
Yeah.
To understand.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why I am here today.
Yeah.
I am very happy to be in this place.
Yeah,
it's
awesome.
Not my first time.
It's not your first time?
Yeah, even last year.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yeah.
But next time you bring a tour guide so that they explain what is happening, so that they remember, especially this part, because maybe 80% of this part are being examined in school.
Yes.
So they will remember more. Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But right now it's for fun, and at least it's good that you are bonding with the little ones.
Yes.
That's so awesome. Where is their mother?
She's not around.
Okay.
Because she's busy.
Okay, yeah. But at least you take time to take them around.
Yeah.
Oh.
I hope maybe next month.
Next month.
Mm.
Oh, that's awesome. You are my hero today.
Amen. Thank you.
Awesome. It's good to take care of the family.
Amen.
I'm learning from you.
Amen.
When I start, I'll be doing the same.
Amen.
Yeah.
Wow, that's
okay.
Good.
Okay.
I like this place because I am also a preacher.
Okay.
I preach. Gospel in Uganda.
Oh,
then Bukwa.
In Bukwa.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Which name? My name.
Yeah, your name.
Fred Wamalo.
So Pastor Fred Wamalo.
Yeah, Pastor Fred Wamalo.
Oh, awesome. So
I
listen
here
come...
Kenya, but I preach in Uganda.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Amen.
My name is Brian Anoto. I normally do documentaries of my travels around the globe.
Okay.
Yeah. The name of my channel is Anoto in China. But now I'm in Kenya, I want people to connect with my story, where I come from.
Wow.
Yeah, so my YouTube channel is called Anoto in China.
Anoto in China.
Yeah, can you say Anoto in China?
Anoto in China.
Awesome, Anoto in China. So you can go check it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
YouTube. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, I am happy to meet you.
Thank you so much, I appreciate it.
Amen.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Awesome.
Yes.
Yeah. This is...
What's your name, Gina?
Okay, introduce yourself.
My name is Lydia Cheng.
Lydia Cheng. And you?
My name is Dana Atieno.
Dana Atieno. Very confident.
Yeah.
Very nice. Awesome. My name is Brian Anoto. Nice to meet you. Okay. In China we say Hangong Xin Ren Xinin. Nice to meet you. Hangong Xin Ren Xinin.
It's very hard.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Awesome. Have a nice time, and we can meet next time or online.
Amen.
Okay.
Online.
Thank you.
I'm going to search you.
Okay. Anoto in China.
Anoto in China.
Yeah.
Wow.
Awesome.
Very nice.
Okay.
Yay.
Thank you.
Amen.
All right. So hope you don't mind.
Yeah, you don't.
Oh, for real. We good? Okay. Okay. Let's continue. So, what's happening here?
Yeah, it's all about here is Golgotha, where Jesus was crucified with the two robbers.
Mm-hmm.
In Jewish community, the only punishment was crucifixion.
Mm-hmm.
If at all that you have sinned or done anything wrong, only punishment or judgment was crucifixion. Now here Jesus was crucified with the two robbers, and this is the robber that repented and went to heaven.
Okay, let me give him my phone number. Simone or two?
Simone.
Okay, you call, or you can text me your number, I'll save.
Okay,
yeah.
Simone,
yeah, you WhatsApp?
Yeah.
But I'll save it.
Okay.
Yeah. And give you a call tomorrow.
I will text you.
Okay. Thank you. All right.
This is the robber that he repented and entered heaven.
This one?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And the other one was the one who was rude.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he went to hell?
Yeah.
Okay.
He was burned on fire.
And you can see the thorn from the tree.
Zizifas Mukranta.
Let me show. This tree. Zizifas Mukranta. This is just an illustration to show you how Jesus was mishandled. Yeah, can you take me a photo here? Okay. The Passion of Christ. Okay. Thank you so much. Nice. You are admiring my photo. The photo is poor quality.
No.
Oh. Okay. So that one, well noted. Photography is poor sight. And what's happening here?
This is the tomb that Jesus' body was laid inside.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and the three women, Mary Magdalene, mm-hmm. Mary mother of James and Salome,
mm-hmm.
came here on a Sabbath day,
mm-hmm.
very early in the morning, mm-hmm. to see if the body of Jesus was there, mm-hmm. so that they can oil it. Then they found no body.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus had already resurrected.
Mm-hmm.
The two soldiers that were guiding the tomb of Jesus
mm-hmm.
were asleep.
Mm-hmm.
Then there was an appearance of an angel
mm-hmm.
who asked the three women, why are they looking for the living among the dead?
Mm-hmm.
Then these three women were shocked
mm-hmm.
and Mary Magdalene was carrying that aloe shemperiana.
This one?
Yeah, that olive oil.
Olive oil, aloe yeah. shemperiana. Oh, the one you showed me.
Yeah.
Actually, now I totally relate.
yeah, it's the one
mm-hmm.
that...
they used to cleanse the body of Jesus.
The body of Jesus.
Okay. And this guy is sleeping.
Yeah, the soldier that was looking at Jesus' tomb.
Okay. Let me show them the tomb of Christ. What's happening?
Jesus is not there. And this guy is sleeping. The angel, Salome, Mary mother of James and Mary Magdalene. Awesome.
Keep going. I hope today it won't rain. So that it will.
Mm.
At what time?
Just now.
Okay, let's keep on keeping. This is now the Jesus ascending into heaven.
Yeah.
Okay. So this part of this. Oh, at least you are their teacher. You teach them.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. And this
Mount Sinai.
Okay, these things I used to be so good at them, but for exams, I have actually lost touch of the Bible stories. So, what happened here?
Moses,
mm-hmm.
this is called Mount Sinai,
mm-hmm.
where Moses went to be given the Ten Commandments by God,
mm-hmm.
and when Moses was still there,
mm-hmm.
the Israelites were tired, then they decided to call Aaron
mm-hmm.
and they made a golden calf
mm-hmm.
and started worshipping it. So when Moses came down from the mountain,
mm-hmm.
he found the Israelites worshipping the golden calf and he threw the stone tablets
mm-hmm.
and they broke.
And God was angry.
Yeah, and God was angry.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is it. But we proceed to the... maybe. In case it rains, we'll have gotten so much about it. But I want to finish maybe at the other end where the weird animals are. Okay, maybe here just to see what's happening because we can't dwell in the whole Bible here. Yeah. Oh, this place, they have documented the almost the whole Bible of the life of Jesus. So if you are a teacher and you need to bring your pupils here for some CRE lessons, geography, this is the best place to be. What and?
This transfiguration of Jesus.
Okay.
Yeah.
Jesus is shining there. Sit here, don't stand. Photograph is what because I wanted to go up to there, but it's so risky, so the stones are weak, right? Okay, we proceed. The rains will catch up with us. And this King Oji, who is King Oji?
This is Philip, the cousin of Goliath.
The?
Cousin of Goliath in the Bible.
Goliath has a cousin that was mentioned in the Bible.
Yeah, King Oji.
Was also a giant?
Yeah.
Oh, what?
Of Canaan were giant like these ones.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah.
What? I didn't know that. King Oji. Alright. And to wrap up with this other end, and then we start walking in the trail.
These are Israelites, and these ones are Edomites, descendants of Esau, mm-hmm. and the Israelites, descendants of Jacob.
Okay.
So they wanted to pass mm-hmm. Edom so that they can go to Canaan,
mm-hmm.
but the Edomites refused them to pass through their land
mm-hmm.
because their land was full of honey, mm-hmm. milk,
mm-hmm.
so sweet things were at Mount Sire.
Okay.
So because they refused, God was angry with them,
mm-hmm.
and He cast this land. Then all the things that were in this land mm-hmm. dried up.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
So this was a cursed land eventually.
Yeah.
Okay. Mount Sire. And what happened to they managed to pass?
Yeah, they passed this Edom land. Then they went to Canaan, the promised
Canaan.
Land.
Okay, okay.
Yeah,
so
here mm-hmm. is now Canaan.
Okay, okay. What? But we're not interested so much about, but it's good just to mention, and then we capture that. So we wrap it up from here. We proceed to the trail.
We cannot go to the trail
mm-hmm.
because of the bridges.
Okay.
Yeah, and also the rivers flooded.
Okay. Yeah. Maybe go to the place where animals are?
Yeah.
Alright. But I'll try on my own going to the bridges. I'll try go around before I exit this place. So let's have one of the best memories around, and then later I'll come alone. The place has been heavily raining.
Yeah.
So it has damaged the
bridges.
The bridges. Okay. How long have you been here at this Nature Conservancy?
2 months.
2 months?
Yeah.
You are from which institute?
Rift Valley Institute.
Rift Valley Institute. Yeah. Where is it based?
Nakuru.
Oh, yeah, Nakuru. And what course did you study?
Tourism management.
Oh, tourism management. Awesome. I did my attachment in Lake Nakuru National Park. Yeah, some years.
You also did tourism?
Yeah.
You also did tourism?
No, the other flip end. I did wildlife management and conservation.
Mm.
Yeah. That's why I'm passionate about nature, traveling, tourism, and just learning new things. There's a shortcut here?
Yeah.
Okay. Homo sapiens. We're going where the animals are, and also where the weird animals are. You'll see them. Maybe they are not genetically straight. They have some deformities. So that's one unique thing about this place. And I thought maybe today being a holiday, people will be so many.
Yeah, in the morning there were so many.
Oh. But right now, just a few people.
Mm-hmm.
I came here some time back in December. The whole of this place, there were tents, events, merry-go-rounds, children playing. A lot of activities were happening. We're going to see the animals and also the very, very weird animals. and I'm here with, once again, introduce yourself.
I'm Sharon.
Sharon.
Yeah.
What about Sharon?
I'm from Kenya.
You're from Kenya?
Yeah.
And you're here at?
KITALE Nature Conservancy.
KITALE Nature Conservancy. And this is ANOTO in China. But right now, ANOTO in China is ANOTO in Kenya. Awesome. So let's see what we've got here. So what's happening here?
These are animals with deformities. Mm-hmm. Like others were born with gene mutation, mm-hmm. others chromosomal mutations. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So like we have this sheep with three legs.
Okay.
Another one with three, and then the other one is too short.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, let me see if I can show you in camera so that you can relate without going away. Animals with chromosomal deformities. Oh my goodness. Where do you guys source these animals from?
Some well-wishers usually brought them,
mm-hmm.
or they can buy.
Okay.
Yeah, if you have one or two,
mm-hmm.
you can just bring.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then they can buy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is this a very expensive?
Mm-hmm. About the price, mm-hmm. I don't know much mm-hmm. about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Very, very weird creatures. Also the big animals, the cows,
yeah.
Donkey.
The cows, yeah.
Okay, we'll see when we get there. Is the lion still here?
Yeah, the lion is still there.
Okay. So this is more of a, how do I call it? Almost like a safari walk or something. Yeah. Have you been to Nairobi Safari Walk?
No.
And you're doing tourism? You need, maybe, but I'm very sure before you are done, you should go there. Maybe.
I will.
Yeah. Okay. And you chose this place because it's home or?
No, it's not because it's home.
Mm.
Well,
this is where the opportunity was.
Yeah.
Where is your home original?
In Soi.
Soi? Yeah, Soi before. Yeah. You guys saw where Soi is in my last episode. Yeah. Because I also documented my journey from Nairobi to KITALE.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you wish to make more memories of yourself while you are traveling? Or maybe while you are showing people around, just your life around you, around your course, or this is too much?
It's not much,
mm-hmm.
but just know you have to make some memories,
mm-hmm.
yeah, so that you can be remembering what you are doing.
So you can also start something like this in the near future?
Yeah.
Okay, I will see. But if you have to do it, do it with passion, a lot of dedication, and take time to grow. And also the best thing about it, because right now you are young and vibrant, you're doing it, for me, I'm doing it for fun. Yeah, so when I get old, I can look back and appreciate my life when I was young, the places I went, and I can show my children, my grandchildren, my friends, my visitors, and we'll appreciate. So just do it for fun. If money starts coming in, well and good. But my motivation is the fun part of it. Yeah. We're going to the other end where the big animals are, and also we'll go to this place, this one. Let's see what's happening. I don't know if there'll be a big deal with the background music, because right now when you post a video on YouTube, it may say the song that's playing in the background is has copyright, so it brings a lot of issues. Your video might be blocked. But anyway, let's just do the thing. Right, so here we are. What's happening here?
These are also some of the animals which have deformities.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we also have the normal ones.
Okay, like yeah. This horse is normal?
No.
Not normal?
It's sick.
Oh, it's sick?
It's one leg is...
Oh, does not touch down?
It usually touches down, but I don't know why it's limping like that one. Or I maybe, guess maybe something has injured it or...
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Maybe it has a deformity somewhere.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see the ones which have... You guys also brought in an llama?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Llama in Kitale. Is llama slaughtered for meat? Or is it just like a donkey?
It's just like a donkey.
I've learned to test it. The llama.
Then these are both male and female.
Oh, this one?
Yeah. But the male one did not protrude well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is like hermaphrodite.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. It can give and it can receive.
But it cannot give.
It cannot give?
Yes. Its female part is just there down, so it cannot give.
What? Let's see. This is a hermaphrodite. The male part not well protruded, but the female part well protruded. Oh, can it give birth?
No, it cannot give birth.
It can't?
Yeah.
What? So it's there in the middle.
There.
Yeah. You know, right now there's an agenda in America. Like, what's your gender? What's your sex? Male or female?
Female.
So right now they have, you can be a female entrapped in a man's body. Have you heard about that? So this may be what they mean, literally. Maybe you can feel like being a man today and the world will embrace you. You can feel, but I don't support that gender. Or that agenda. What about this other one?
This one leg is like that one,
mm-hmm.
But it's just functions well.
Let's see. Only for this, the leg has somehow
bent. Yeah.
Since it was young.
Yeah.
Okay. And the other one looks like struggling too much. This one.
Yeah, that one has breathing difficulties.
Breathing difficulties?
Yeah, because its neck has turned.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What, do you know the name of that condition? Because also I see some humans have that condition. I'm not so familiar with that. But I'll check it later. Let me show them. This one is normal. This one is normal. Also this. But this one, the unique thing about it is the horns.
Yeah.
Is it friendly? You don't, you're not certain about it.
But from Uganda.
From Uganda?
Yeah. Ankole.
Ankole. Let's stand here. You know, sometimes if you see it doing that way, it might be approximating the time it would take to attack you. From Ankole, Uganda.
From Uganda, uh-huh. It's called Ankole.
This one is called Ankole. Big horns. Let me see. The lion is roaring.
Yeah.
It's, maybe it's hungry. Okay, and here?
Those ones are normal, then this one is dwarf.
This one is dwarf?
Yeah.
This one, let's see. Lama. Thank you. Adilama. So, the ilama here, very amazing creature. Ilama, is this a mixture of the horse and something else, or?
Goat and camel.
Oh, ilama is a mixture of goat and camel.
Yeah.
And it can actually give birth.
Yeah.
This one came while it was pregnant.
No, there was a male one here, and then it went away.
Why, what do you mean? Did it die?
It did not die.
It ran.
They took it away from the park.
Look at the lion. Why did they take it away?
I don't know. Yeah.
Somebody else bought it, or?
Yeah, I just guess. Somebody bought it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Any other thing which is unique? The other one has one horn.
One horn, and it has a blue eye.
Blue eye?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then its tail is like the one for the horse.
For real?
Yeah.
And I can't. Let me move close. You are very afraid of animals. Why? Come close. Oh, maybe it's very, very, very. It can knock you down.
Yeah.
It's very aggressive. This one is monohorn, one horn, and blue. Which both eyes are blue?
Yeah, that's blue.
It will be a deformity of so many. You know, this thing in the cow is called tapetum lucidum. The one, if you go out in the night and with a torch, if you were to, how do you call, put the rays on the eye of the cow, you see it, it's very bright. So maybe this tapetum lucidum has been excess. Maybe it's a deformity for that tapetum lucidum. Let me show them the tail. You see, the tail looks like the one of a horse. This tail. Normally a cow's tail should be like this one. But this one looks like this. Awesome. So that's it about this other end. And these horses?
These are normal.
Yeah. And what's happening over there?
Boat riding.
Yeah. So I think we go up to there, we see, and then we come finish from this end. So because this will be the first episode of this series, and then starting from this end will be the second episode. So let's have a quick look of what's happening on the other end, and then we come to begin the other episode. And the third episode will be about the nature trail. But she has said I'll have to go alone. Maybe you don't have proper shoes for the trail.
I'm afraid of the bridges.
Oh, the bridges.
Yeah.
heights or?
No. Mm-hmm. They can fly. Okay. You know, they are not in a good condition.
Okay.
But you can just go slowly, slowly, slowly.
Okay.
And then
okay.
Pass the bridge.
Yeah. But riding is free.
Yeah.
Why? Why is it free? Boat ride is free. Last time I came, it was around 200 shillings. Let's see what's happening in this end. Near Kopoa. Boat riding is free. It's free, but. Oh, yeah, yeah. Should we do the boat ride now or we should do it later? what time are you here up to? 5 o'clock, 6?
Some few minutes, like 30 minutes.
30 minutes? Okay. What do you think? Can we just do like 5 minutes?
Yeah.
But later I'll come alone and then you take me. Okay, let's do the boat ride for a few minutes. Ladies first, but do you trust that here? Okay. There she goes, and then I follow. You steady? Okay, so my turn. I can sit. Okay, sorry, men are a bit rough. You are very smooth. Okay, awesome, come. So that's our driver, our captain. Unaomba shot? Oh, tot.
Yeah.
Tot na short is the same. Ah, wait. No. Okay, okay. What is he saying?
You should see her.
Oh, I saw her. Hi, I saw you. I saw you, it's okay. But she was busy. So, this is our captain. What's the name of our captain?
Josephat.
Josephat. Josephat. Let me get your angle. And he's doing his thing. So, the water is calm. What's happening on this other end? So let me show you a better angle. This is us. That is Sharon. And we are at this place. This place. So we have better angles. This place. Awesome. We doing a very, very brief boat ride for us to finalize this episode. But I want to come again when I'm done with the nature thing. I hope I find you here. And then we can have a small conversation and then we wrap it up. So don't go.
I can't go.
Yeah, I will take care of you, don't worry.
As long as you have already told me to wait for you.
Okay, okay. You'll be here. Okay, okay. Is this natural or man-made?
It's
natural.
It's water.
The water, yeah. Natural?
It has an outlet and an
inlet. Oh, it has outlet and inlet, so it's natural.
Yeah, it's natural.
Oh, this is awesome. If you have very, very big land, you could do such a thing. Although this one is very, very natural. Awesome. So, do you take us back? Yeah, and then we go finish with her on the other end, and then I'll come back.
Okay, fine.
Okay, and we'll have a conversation. You seem so scared. Look at how she's holding. Are you afraid of?
Scared. I can also go trade.
For real?
Yeah.
Here or in Kisumu?
Here.
Okay. You go take.
Yeah, I can go trade.
For real?
I usually go trade.
Okay, take us up to that end. Okay. Challenge accepted. I hold this for you.
Yeah.
Okay. So she can both try. Let's see how she can spin it. Yeah. Oh. Oh, I sit down. What? Oh, you're. What? What? But you are used to cook ugali, so. You know, this thing is like you are cooking ugali, so it's easier for her.
Not easy, honey. Yeah.
Okay, but I will try it, not here. This is all your time, so shine with it. I want to see how you park there. I want to see how she parks there. So, what?
This is not the first time for
her. Oh, she has done it several.
Yeah.
And then you will teach me also.
Yeah, you will even need to try.
But she wants to go away. Or will you be around here? Okay. Anyway, we'll finish with her on the other end and then I'll come alone. Yeah, so don't mind. Yeah. Oh, are you supposed to go somewhere? Yeah.
I'm around, but if someone needs water,
Okay. She wants to park with the reverse. That's what you want to do, right? What? She is parking with the reverse. Very amazing. So she takes it ahead, the head should face that way, and then she'll start reversing. Yeah. So that's how she is doing it. If I stand, will it be stable?
Yeah, you will be stable.
Let's see how she does it.
Yeah, that's right.
So that's reverse gear. It's not, it's manual, not automatic. But the reverse. You balance.
What? It's enjoyable.
Do you have a license for.
You can also control with the hand, and then as long as you reach here, no problem.
Yeah. Yeah. What?
You can even use
the hand.
Not the hand.
So that way it's packed?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, you pack it well.
Oh, that's so nice. See, she has actually packed it, and the most interesting thing is when she does the reverse. She goes like, just how you do to a car. You go ahead and then you come back. awesome. But I wanted to finish this video from this point. So let me come out of this place and then I'll come again. And he will teach me how to boat ride. Okay. Yes. Can you take me one more photo here? This is my phone. Here. Okay, so one more photo. Okay. And then come out of this place and finish this episode from here and begin another one. There are actually three boats. 1, 2, 3, or in Chinese, Yi, A, San. Three boats, and I'm coming back to ride this one. This one is owned by you, or you are just the driver?
Oh, others are not around at this time.
Okay, so, but this is yours?
This is mine.
Okay.
I normally use this Kapenguri.
Kapenguri, it has a name?
Yeah, this I-10.
I-10?
Yeah.
Or this is 10?
I normally use Kapenguri, the other one. But
okay.
Yeah, awesome. Mostly.
Awesome. Yeah. All right. Yeah. So I'm coming back. What's your name one more time?
Josephat.
This is Josephat, and this is Anoto in China. See you
next time, man.
In the next episode.
Yeah.
I'm coming back to do a portrait with this guy, okay. Josephat.
Yeah.
Yeah. So don't go. I'm around here.
Yeah, I'm around.
You're around.
I'm around.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wanted to do the trail, then I can finish here.
Okay. No.
So maybe I'll do the trail within 30 minutes and come.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah. So don't go.
Fine.
Okay. And I'll appreciate you.
Even
in a small way.
You.
Okay. Don't worry. Okay. All right. So, hello. So we've done with that part, and she's been our assistant driver, and we want to go to the other end. Is this your phone? Awesome. We want to go to the other end, and we appreciate what's happening there. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is Anoto in China, and this is
Sharon in Kenya.
Sharon in Kenya. Maybe she'll start a YouTube channel and she'll be documenting about this place. She'll be Sharon in Kenya. Okay, why should I? Why am I saying this? But if you want to do it, just do it. Yeah. This horse, what's up? No, not horse, the donkey. This. So, hit. This is how men chase ladies here in Kenya. So that one is a lady, and that one is a man. And the lady is throwing kicks. What? Maybe it wants to have some tax. There it goes. The lady does not want, but the man wants. Look at that. The male horse wants its rights, but the female is like the government. It does not want to give the citizen its rights. So we finish with that. So this is the first episode of Kitale Conservancy. See you in the next episode. This is Anoto in China, and that has been Sharon in Kenya. Now maybe she'll start a YouTube channel if we start support her. Anyway, I exit and take you to the next end of what's happening here. So the next video will start at this bridge. So see you in the next episode. This is Anoto in China.